playing in her first finals, trying to close out her first title. Abrumike and Fowles will jump it up, and game five is underway. Beard starts on a mad dash inside to Carson for an easy two on the first possession.
What a great sign for Los Angeles. Essence Carson has struggled to score throughout the course of the series, except for an excellent performance in game three.
In game three, she went 4 of 4 from deep. Here's Fowles, an early touch for her, denied by Abrumike, and last hit Fowles, Los Angeles basketball.
Cheryl Reed was telling her team this morning at shoot-around, we need to get Sylvia Fowles more involved. Everything she got in game four, she created for herself off of the offensive glass.
Fowles has been maybe the steadiest performer of these finals for either team. Parker finds two defenders. Here's Carson. Off on the three, and that's out of bounds as Abrumike was lining up the offensive rebound.
Ryan, you saw Nneka Ogumike going to the glass. That is going to be important for Los Angeles. Minnesota has really owned the rebound differential in this series, especially in terms of second chance points.
Well, we asked Nneka Ogumike to fill in the blank. You will win tonight if what? And she said, if I rebound. Whalen connects.
You saw all the defensive attention that Maya Moore drew. Brian Agler will send multiple bodies at her. She is that dangerous offensively.
Coming off 31 points in game four, her finals high. That was too much of a squeeze from Beer. Moore pulls up. Brunson. Got it. Rebecca Brunson averaging 9.5 points per game in this series, shooting it at 52%, has had her mid-range. Good look there from Abrumike, but Moore there for the foul.
LA has to be pleased in terms they want to be moving and cutting. Yes, Maya Moore got a lot of the forearm of Essence Carson. That's a good call. But you see the spacing because LA sets up on the perimeter. They will have the space for their cutters to get through the lane.
Carson to the line after the first personal on Maya Moore. You know, we talked to Cheryl Reeve, Minnesota Lynx head coach, who is the winningest coach in playoff history. Before the season, she told us this group deserves a repeat. This core deserves a repeat. Brought it up to her team at the beginning of the year, said we're going to own this goal. And here they are, one win away from achieving it.
When you look at four of the five starters have been here since 2011, since this team started to go on this tear.
Since, as Simone Augusta said, you could play pick a seat in the crowd. Not tonight. It's jammed. Moore, nifty one dribble. Tolliver. Sets the screen for Parker, and she puts it home, and these teams look sharp early.
And a player to keep an eye on for Los Angeles is Candace Parker. When she has activity on the offensive end of the floor, with and without the basketball, she is effective.
Fouls to a wide-open Brunson. Denied by Abrumike, and it hit Brunson's leg. She went for the body instead of the bucket.
Yeah, she was open on the left side, but she went to try to get the foul instead, and not the right move there.
Whoa, Abrumike got slammed, and that's a foul on Sylvia Fowles. Well, Brian Agler won a championship with Seattle in 2010. And interestingly enough, he played in back-to-back game fives when he was coaching Columbus in the ABL and won both of them in 1997 and 1998.
His players do not have experience in this situation. He does.
Turnover from Tolliver. She had three in game four after just two total between games one and three. Fouls working Parker. Spun into Abrumike. Loose ball, and it's picked up by LA.
Parker doing a nice job forcing Fouls to catch the ball farther out from the basket than she'd like.
Parker on the move. Meets Brunson. Forces it up. Denied by Brunson. No call. It's going the other way.
You see LA picking up with three-quarter court pressure. This at times has bothered Minnesota, has caused them to turn it over and led to easy scores the other way.
Brunson harassed by Agwumike, forces it up, and that's going to be a foul on LA. As we check in with Tom.
Well, in the last game, Candace Parker got caught up a little bit talking to the referees, frustrated about the officiating, and rightfully so. She gets hammered at times. On that last foul that wasn't called, it looked like Rebecca Brunson got a piece of her. No foul was called. Candace went to argue with the refs, and her teammate, Essen Carson, immediately went up to her and gave her the universal signal for cut it out. You can tell that they want to have more composure, less arguing, and not focus on things they can't control.
It's absolutely correct, especially in these situations. Doesn't matter what's happening outside of you in terms of the crowd or the officials. You have to take care of what you can take care of.
Well, Brian Agler said poise was the key word coming out of game four. He thought they played with the right energy, the right effort, but not the right poise. Tolliver, nice look there, and Beard cashes in.
How good has Elena Beard been in this series? She plays tremendous defense. You see her picking up Lindsey Whalen, so she can't get the ball inbounded. And offensively, she's produced.
Moore has hit her first two. Beard separates. Can't connect inside. Agwumike is lucky she didn't get hit with her second personal.
Right now, both teams playing with great activity on both ends of the floor. What we saw in game four as well.
And there's Beard trying to go for the steal. Augustus averts. Can't connect. Brunson. So active. Finds Whalen in traffic. And that is going to be a foul, I believe, on Agwumike. And that is number two.
And Ryan, we have seen that here in the finals. Nneka Agwumike is foul prone. She plays with a lot of activity, but she told us it's more important for me to play with energy than it is for me to worry about fouls early on.
She also thinks she is excellent at avoiding foul number six, and the numbers back it up.
She has not fouled out of the game this season.
And that's going to be a foul on Tolliver. Her first. Well, to piggyback on what Holly was saying, talking about the poise and can LA handle this adversity right now being tested early on a few whistles. They shop WNBAstore.com tonight after the game for championship gear. WNBAstore.com, one store, every team.
They already have the championship t-shirts made up, you think?
Well, yeah. I mean,
it's amazing how they know.
Yeah.
I shouldn't tell you this, but they make up both.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Renee Montgomery checks into the game for Minnesota. We'll give Lindsey Whalen a breather. Cheryl Reeve told us her biggest concern for this game was their bench. They need something from Montgomery or Cruz. They've both been quiet in this series. Carson bombs away. Oh, no, that didn't look good from the hand.
Well, Renee Montgomery, she was the second most efficient three-point shooter to Maya Moore this season for Minnesota.
Moore can't hit there, and Agwumike snatched that rebound. Montgomery, nice front of Tolliver there to deny the ball. Parker will pop. Can't hit. Beard on the offensive glass, clearly hit, no call, and now a jump. Timeout on the floor. These teams feeling out each other early and good activity.
Moore has won at every single level. The excellence that she brings, I'm not a math expert, but I've added this up. It's almost a 90% win rate in her career. We asked her coach why, and she said Maya is never satisfied. She always wants more.
Nice little pun from Cheryl Reeve that she gave Holly. Meanwhile, Maya Moore has scored or assisted on all four of the field goals for Minnesota so far in this winner-take-all game five. And here, turns it over as fouls couldn't handle. Minnesota has had more turnovers in every game of this series. LA has won that battle. Minnesota has won the rebounding battle. That's been pretty consistent throughout the series. Parker in rhythm, got it to go, and much less hesitation on that attempt from three than what we've seen so far in this series.
First three she has made so far in the finals, 0 for 6 before that. In these playoffs, she had been 1 of 11.
That's after she shot it at 38% during the regular season. Perkins? No. Parker indeed pushing. Beard, good hesitation. Nifty swivel to the rim.
Maya Moore with one foul. Wanted to make sure she did not pick up a second. But now Elena Beard on Maya Moore. How much more difficult will her touches become?
Fouls? No. And three straight stops from LA. And Parker again in transition, but just dribbled it off the left.
Elena Beard throughout this series has done a great job of attacking the rim, especially in transition. She's lefty, so Maya gives a little hesitation, and great job by Beard to finish.
Well, we asked Brian Agler after LA took a 2-1 series lead who his MVP would be, and the LA head coach said Elena Beard.
She is so disruptive on the defensive end. You see right here, trying to prevent Maya from even touching the ball.
And Moore didn't get off a great look. It results in another stop. Tolliver finds Gray, who had 20 off the bench in game four. Parker, who thought it was down, it was halfway. Minnesota has missed its last five shots after starting 4 of 6, and Agumake deflects that out.
They haven't been able to get Maya Moore easy touches because Elena Beard's guarding her. They're doing a great job, LA is, of pushing Sylvia Fowles out of deep post position.
Hey, Philly!
I'm just gonna guess they're running Philly here.
I think you might be right.
Moore gives it up. Nice look to Fowles inside. Third assist for Maya Moore in this first quarter.
And Maya Moore gets that much attention, another player will be open, and she has become such a good passer.
A little bit low on the pass. Beard inside, but it'll be a clean block in LA basketball.
It's not very often in basketball where two separate players get to block the same shot, but it happens here. First Rebecca Brunson, and then for good measure Sylvia Fowles.
Now we'll have to check with official stats, but did they both get credit for a block there?
They should.
I think for now it'll be Brunson. One to shoot. Gray just got it off, but not a good looking attempt. Perkins stumble. Gray collects with numbers. Moore hustling. Gray finds Beard. Patient. Can't finish. Parker will try and will finish.
And that is one of the things that has really hurt Minnesota more than anything are the live ball turnovers that lead to points the other way.
How about the start for Parker? 7 points and 3 rebounds.
That's the kind of activity Brian Agler's team needs.
Fouls, the long arms and the footwork. But she trapped.
A great catch, but in order to corral the pass, she did stumble her feet.
Hey! Hey! Luke three! Luke three! Luke three! Luke three! Luke three!
They're not running Philly.
Four turnovers apiece to begin this game. Beard, too strong. And now she's in the backcourt. So Moore won't have to deal with her here. Open. It's good for Gia Perkins. And assist number 4 for Maya Moore. Perkins has been by far the most consistent performer off the bench for Minnesota in this series. That's a force from Parker. Good D from Moore and Brunson. Whalen zipping through the lane. Couldn't finish. Fouls. Loose ball. And another try for Minnesota. Moore. Got it. Brian Agler wanted help for Christy Tolliver and never came.
Christy Tolliver, only 5'7", forced Maya Moore into a tough shot, but Ryan, after these finals, I don't know what's a tough shot for Maya Moore anymore.
6 points, 4 assists in quarter number one for the former MVP. A 3 second difference game in shot clock. Lavender alone, you bet. Three seconds left in the quarter. Whalen all the way in, blocked by Parker, and that'll do it. In an active first. 5 lead changes already. But perhaps good news for Minnesota, the team that has won quarter number one, has won the first 4 games of this 5-game series.
So far in the first quarter.
That's a good question. You know, at times we're moving the ball, we're making good cuts, and other times we're trying to go one-on-one and playing the congestion. So it's got to be more of a balance towards the activity. And we'll have our chances to go one-on-one, but we got to break their defense down first.
You've talked about Maya Moore getting more attention. Whether she's scoring, she's getting assists. How do you control both things?
I'd much rather have her get assists.
Sounds good, Coach.
Okay, thanks.
Brian Agler knows that if Maya Moore gets hot on the offensive end in terms of her shooting, it can be a very long night. And there is another turnover, Ryan, for Minnesota.
5th turnover for the Lynx. Meanwhile, Maya Moore has scored or assisted on all 7 field goals from the Lynx. Carson, Agumake, Tolliver, Lavender, and Gray on the floor for L.A. Carson waits. Can't hit. Agumake flags it down. Tries to save it. Volley to Carson. What a play by Perkins. Getting her hands in there twice and letting her defense get set. 6 to shoot. Gray muscling and turning it over. 5 turnovers apiece. Whalen trying to give it right back. It ends up with Moore. Augustus. Yeah.
The last possession for Los Angeles, they did have good ball movement. They want to make Minnesota play defense for a decent amount of the shot clock.
Are you seeing some jitters here with these turnovers from both teams?
I think there is a little bit of nerves. I think there's a lot of activity by the hands to cause them.
Agumake, you bet. Her first bucket of the night. The MVP was quiet in game four, just 10 field goal attempts and 11 points.
And Ryan, right now, Minnesota going with their small lineup. Maya Moore playing the four. They were so effective in that with that lineup in game four.
Augustus off on the three. Good box out from Lavender. Here's Gray through traffic. Out to Carson. Off again on a three.
Wide open. Essence Carson is the player Minnesota will leave. She's got to make those.
Whalen, such good body balance. Seventh lead change already of this winner-take-all game five. Lavender has size on Moore. Nice look there to Carson. Squeezed it up and off. Nice D from Minnesota. Agumake finally cleans it up.
Great activity by Nneka Agumake. She's the type of player who can get involved even when things are not run for her because she is so good on the offensive glass.
Whalen having trouble with the handle in this game. Lost it. And it's LA basketball.
I thought the defender tipped it from behind.
She's either going to have to help us or she's not going to play. We'll find somebody else.
I think Brian Agler a bit frustrated with Chelsea Gray. She's the type of player who's difficult to defend because she will break a play and go and just try to create things, but when it's not working, can hurt your team.
Lavender can't hit. Agumake active inside, but Brunson ends up with it, and a foul is called, I believe, on Essence Carson. Interesting, Rebecca, when you just mentioned Chelsea Gray, it was Candace Parker who went over to her then, put her hands on her face and tried to calm her down after that talking to from Brian Agler.
And that's what you need your star and your leader to do. Keep her composure when she's on the floor, and then when she's not on the floor, to keep things, keep players alive on the bench.
Brian Agler lauded the leadership of Candace Parker. Doesn't think she gets enough credit for it. Augustus trapped. Eight to shoot. Howard, patient, and that's why.
Howard has tremendous patience, especially for a young player. She does not get sped up when she gets the ball inside.
Lavender has size in that matchup as well. But this isn't really her game. Trying to make it her game. Can't.
Game four, Minnesota struggled with Maya Moore on the bench. It's important for them to keep a lead or to build on it with Maya not in the game.
Inside, nice activity from Brunson, and a foul on Nika Grubike, and that is her third personal.
And that will force Nika Grubike to go to the bench.
Stay up, okay?
One of the reasons that's so significant is she is the one who has really attacked the glass, and that's the key that Brian Agler set, one of the keys. We've got a rebound.
He said the margin on the glass cannot be too large. Right now it's a plus one for Minnesota, and now Carson is here with a personal. Her second. And you can see Candace Parker this time saying relax.
And sometimes the best thing that can happen for a player who's getting frustrated on the floor, put them on the bench, let them watch. She's regained her composure, now leading her team.
And that's going to be a jump ball with Howard. Nice hands from Candace Parker.
LA's had tremendous activity in terms of their hands defensively.
And Parker to jump. Parker slaps it ahead to Tolliver, trying to get ahead of the field, and was fouled by Perkins from behind. Could that be a clear path foul? That's what Candace Parker is screaming.
That's two shots and the ball back.
We'll get a chance to take a look here. That is a clear path, Ryan. I mean, it's tough because often clear path fouls, they're actually trying to foul. This one, she's trying to hit from behind, but intent doesn't matter. That's a clear path.
And that's a big call in a tight game.
If they listen to me, if they double you, space the outside, but we got to pull back to the ball as well, okay? Pressure's bothering them, so listen to me. We're pressuring, we're jamming things up, but we're not playing back quick enough into plays. Okay, so post player, once you get in that trap, so they get out. You got to swing back to the ring and find people. Got it?
So no player between Christy Tolliver and the basket. So by definition, Ryan, that's a clear path, and that's going to be the clear path call.
Eric Bruden with a very quick call after seeing those two replays. And it is indeed a clear path foul against Minnesota. Pretty easy review, and Eric Bruden did so efficiently.
And during that review, you heard Brian Agler talking to his team and saying our pressure is bothering them. And that's the thing that's really hurt Minnesota, has been LA's pressure in the games that they have lost. When LA wins, they're at plus 30 in points off turnovers. When Minnesota's won, they're a plus 6.
Holly?
Well, Minnesota has assistants on the staff here who chart deflections in the first half of this game right now. And you're absolutely right. LA with 8 deflections compared to just 6 for Minnesota. So they have been harassing and upsetting this Minnesota offense.
Paul Holly didn't like math.
She's really debunking that theory. Now twice tonight showing off her arithmetic skills. Meanwhile, Christy Tolliver, just 11 of 14 from the line in this series, which, you know, I mean, there's nothing shabby about that, but she is normally nails from the line, 90% in her career, just under it.
But I also like Brian Agler sending her to the line because she hasn't gotten many touches, hasn't had a chance to get any shots up, help get her in a rhythm.
They put 21 on the shot clock. Parker, double comes. She didn't see it. Moore did. The steal, the save, and now Parker the foul. Fourth team foul on LA, and the first personal on Parker.
We saw this at the end of game four. Maya Moore saved the possession by getting a steal. Now this is a situation, Ryan, normally you would say, all right, your teammates have to tell you it's coming. This building is loud. They may have told her it was coming. She may not have heard.
Lynx set a record with their crowd. Game five last year, a finals win against Indiana. They were expecting to break it today. And that foul, by the way, was given to Christy Tolliver, not to Candace Parker. So two on Tolliver as Augustus rattles home the J. And in game two, when Minnesota won on their home floor, this was about the time they separated. Dream Gruda did not play in game four, getting minutes here. Okwumike on the bench with three fouls. Beard, no.
Maya Moore has been able to roam defensively. Her assignment is Essence Carson, and Essence hasn't made any shots. That's let Maya be almost playing in a one-person zone.
Montgomery gives it up. Brunson denied by Parker. Tolliver finds space. You bet.
That's where Christy Tolliver is so dangerous in transition. They run her out off a lot of stuff in the half court, but she gets momentum when she gets those open looks.
We saw Magic Johnson applauding. Christy Tolliver told us him talking to the team post game four in the locker room made a world of difference because you could hear a pin drop. They were crushed. In Christy's words, so heartbroken to not clinch at home. Augustus, a tough look on the baseline.
Magic Johnson told him, this is why you play a five-game series. I know what it's like to win a game seven in Boston Garden. It can be done, ladies.
And they really bought in to what their co-owner had to say. Tolliver switched on Brunson. Not that time, but Parker, the mismatch on Montgomery. Carson. Six to shoot. Parker tried the over-the-head pass and could not get it in.
Because Maya Moore is able to sag off in that help defense.
Neither team has led by more than four in this first half thus far. 11 lead changes. Moore. Again. 8 points, five assists, four rebounds for Maya Moore. And a timeout taken by LA.
Maya Moore knows how to get done on both ends of the floor. Ryan, such a nasty woman. Take a look at how she's able to play help side, leaving Essence Carson. Essence has struggled throughout the course of this series, already 0-for-3 from the three-point line tonight. Maya taking advantage of that defensively.
And you see entering this game how much better LA shot from three at home than they have on the road. Carson, a huge reason why. She's 0-10 from three in this building this series, 4-of-6 in LA.
She had the one game where she went 4-for-4, has struggled outside of that. She's a good defensive presence, but she's been a liability offensively here so far.
And you can see that on this possession again. Five to shoot. Beard trying to slip it back door off the foot of Minnesota.
She did not kick the basketball. It was thrown off her foot. There's a difference.
And the difference is the shot clock. Because she didn't kick it, the shot clock does not reset to 14. It stays at three.
Exactly.
Tommy, kick!
And that's why Brian Agler's trying to say it's a kick ball, but it is not. Parker has to put it up. It connects! 9 points, six rebounds in an active first half for the two-time MVP. Seeking her first title. Brunson and Parker got locked up a little bit there as Parker tried to jump Brunson for the steal. Three to shoot. Augustus is going to have to heave. Doesn't get it off in time, and that's a shot clock violation.
The ball got stuck on one side of the floor for Minnesota because of the denied D.
Well, Candace Parker has it going on tonight. She's been huge in wins for her team. A buzzer-beating win for L.A. Game two, a response here in Minnesota for the Lynx. A thunderous performance from L.A. in game three, and then a back-and-forth excellent contest in game four with Maya Moore of Minnesota prevailing. And here in game five, a winner-take-all game five, we've had 11 lead changes, and neither team has led by more than four as Parker insists her way to the line.
And this is what we did not see from Candace Parker in game four, and that's a relentless pursuit of the paint. Whether on the dribble or cutting through the lane, this is the activity Brian Agler talks about in terms of the importance it is to LA.
Candace Parker to the line. Her first free throws of the night. As we check in with Holly.
Well, Minnesota called that last timeout. Cheryl Reeve was livid after that shot clock violation, yelling at guard Lindsey Whalen, you've got to get open. And then she looked right at Sylvia Fowles, her 6'6 center, who has just 2 points in this game, and said, you've got to be an option. I need you at a higher level. She challenged Fowles to get involved.
Fowles, the MVP of the finals a season ago, playing her second year with Minnesota, her first full season. Whalen drops it off to Moore. Again! Maya Moore is 5 of 7, 10 points, 5 assists, and 4 boards.
I think Maya Moore is ready to play today, Ryan.
I do. Lavender. Over to Carson, giving a lot of space. Carson goes in, and that's going to be a charge. And it's foul number three on Essence Carson.
There was a screen up top. Maya Moore can go behind because she's not worried about Carson taking a three. Gets in. Yep. I think she was set. Legal guarding position right there.
Chelsea Gray is into the game for LA, along with Carson, Parker, Lavender, and Beard. Christy Tolliver getting ready to check back in for the Sparks. Augustus finding space. You bet. First half points for Simone Augustus. Moore went for the steal and knocked it out of bounds.
The balance that Minnesota has on the offensive end of the floor. Maya Moore cuts through, but there goes the other wing, Simone Augustus. She said she was feeling good this morning at shoot around, and she's been performing here in the first half.
Augustus started 0-4, has hit her last three. Minnesota has assisted on every one of their field goals, 14 for 14. Parker, the turnaround. Difficult look, couldn't get it. Beard went for the rebound. 3-on-2. Brunson lays it up and off. Fouls. Can't put it home. Rebound Beard and a missed opportunity there for Minnesota. Another stagnant looking LA possession. Gray switched on Brunson. Five to shoot. Parker trying to pass out of it. Two to shoot. Gonna have to put it up. And an air ball. Nice defense there for Minnesota. Beard trying to come up with a steal. Now Tolliver will come up with a foul. And that'll be number three on Christy Tolliver.
Christy Tolliver frustrated because she's trying to be active on the defensive end of the floor. And a couple times in this game, she's been called for those little touches.
It puts LA over the limit. Three fouls for Tolliver, three for Abumake, and three for Carson. They're coming up on the WNBA Halftime Report presented by State Farm. WNBA President Lisa Borders will chat with Holly. Plus, we'll have a look back at 2016 playoff moments and first half analysis.
We'll see how those fouls play out in the second half because LA has a very short bench. Agler's been only going seven deep in these finals.
Largest lead of the game for either team. Minnesota up six, seeking their fourth title in the last 6 years. And Minnesota has a foul to give. They give it. But that was Maya Moore. And that will be your second personal.
Even with a foul to give, if you're Maya Moore, I don't think you waste one there, Ryan.
Right, right. Let somebody else take that or just play the possession straight up. 6 seconds left in the half. Gray fading away. No. Moore collects. Trying to heave. Didn't get it off in time. And that'll do it. Minnesota ends the half on a 6-0 run. Triple-double watch for Maya Moore, who has 12 points, 5 rebounds, and 5 assists. 3 steals for Moore as well as we check in with Holly.
Simone, how do you describe the sense of urgency in your team's huddle right now?
We're just ready to play. We're scrambling around on defense, trying to get deflections, trying to make it difficult for Candace or any of the top three players on that team. And right now it just feels good. We're in a great flow.
Second half to a championship, a fourth title for this team. What will it take?
Everything. Grit, grind, determination, poise, all of that. We got to just stick to it.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Well, Simone Augustus hit her final 3 shots of the half. And Minnesota leads it 34-28. A half away from it, ready to start the third quarter of Game 5 of this best-of-5 finals. And Minnesota with a 6-point lead. Ryan Rucco alongside Rebecca Lobo welcoming you courtside here at Target Center. Tightly played first half. This is the largest lead that either team has had at any point. It's only 6 points. This is sort of what we've seen from these two teams throughout the entire year.
Yeah, great energy from both teams going back and forth. You would expect LA in the second half to get a little more production from Kristy Colliver, more from Neko Gumike. She spent some time on the bench for foul trouble.
Minnesota, meanwhile, has got tons of production from Maya Moore, and that is our State Farm Exist to Assist.
Well, you take a look at Maya Moore. Minnesota does a great job running their players off of screens in order to get shots. But take a look at the attention that Maya Moore draws. You see Candace Parker coming out. Beard comes out. So how does Minnesota capitalize? Rebecca Brooks, Sylvia Fowles, goes to the rim. Great pass by Maya Moore. She's got vision to get it there. And then another way Maya has been effective is getting to the block on the smaller Carson. But when the double comes, instead of going into it, she fades away. She's just been so effective offensively here.
Well, Maya Moore, Game 5 last year, a game that Minnesota won, somehow they did win, in spite of 5 points and a 1-of-4 shooting night for Maya Moore. Much different story so far tonight for Maya Moore.
Very involved on the offensive end, and she has really had great vision to find open teammates.
Let's check in with Holly Rowe.
Asking LA coach Brian Agler what he addressed with his team in the locker room at the half, and he said, you know, we've just got to stay in plays better defensively off of Minnesota's down screen action. Rebecca, that's what you just addressed. He says, we get lost on that action. We've got to stay in those plays. He likes how they're hanging around on the rebounds, just down 4 in the rebounding category. And when I asked him about his MVP, Neko Ogumike, getting more involved, he said, look, she was in foul trouble, having to take her in and out and in and out. That really affected her rhythm. He said, I have no doubt Neko is going to get going.
Well, we talked with Neko Ogumike today, and she said she was feeling very relaxed. She said all of those emotions you think are associated with a Game 5, she actually felt in Game 4, and she thought it gave her team just not quite the right edge. As she termed it, piggybacking off Brian Agler, they were trying to win a championship instead of trying to beat their opponent. Let's see if she can pick up what was a quiet first half with just 4 points. Augustus got going at the end of the second quarter. Brunson, no, and the long rebound to Tolliver.
Kristy Tolliver, a player I think Brian Agler wants to have more involved. Only 2 field goal attempts in the first half.
Parker's given all kinds of space, will take and hit from 3.
clearly a defensive breakdown by Minnesota. Candace Parker, while she has struggled with her three through the first four games of the series, not tonight.
2 of 3 from deep tonight. She had been 1 of 11 in the series. Moore from the corner. Almost got the roll. Parker gets the board and has it knocked away out of bounds. Minnesota basketball. The last hit, Parker.
She hit that.
But LA has done a nice job of cleaning up the defensive glass, an area they've struggled games 1 through 4. And Parker's a player who can handle the ball. No, she thought Maya Moore touched it, but that was off of Parker.
That's the right call. Last hit, Candace Parker. 9th turnover for LA. One more than Minnesota. Augustus separates and hits. Augustus started 0-4, has hit her last 4.
And she has been a difference maker in the finals. When she plays well, Minnesota wins.
That's a significant little swing after that turnover. With LA trying to build some momentum. Agwumike storms in, can't finish. Brunson collects. Moore leans in and gets the whistle. And that is foul number 4 on Christy Tolliver.
And what did Brian Agler tell us today? Maya Moore is cagey at drawing fouls. She gets the player in the air, leans in.
Moore had shot just 8 free throws the first 3 games of this series. Went to the line 12 times in game 4. She misses here. Hey, next week, opening week for the NBA season. Taking a look at the upcoming NBA national TV schedule. Full slate of games across the NBA networks. Tuesday, the key NBA tip-off on TNT, a doubleheader. Knicks at Cleveland, Spurs at Golden State. Then Wednesday on ESPN, Philly hosts Russell Westbrook and OKC. Then Houston at LA. For more on these games, please go to NBA.com or visit the NBA app. Knocked out of bounds by Brunson. So, Rebecca, let me just ask you this, because I'm sure some of the fans at home are wondering. 4 fouls now on Tolliver. We saw 3 on Agwumike, 3 on Carson. Have you generally been okay with these calls?
I think some of them have been touch fouls early on. I think there are a lot of whistles. You, in this situation, more than anything, want to see the players allowed to play.
Agwumike wasn't in the first half. Looked like she was hit here. Follows it up, though, and lays it in.
And she is in attack mode. She's frustrated that she did not get the call on that one.
And Sylvia Fowles is shaken up, grabbing her hand as she comes up top of your screen. Moore, got it. And it looks like Fowles needs a timeout. Cheryl Reeve is yelling at her team to foul. Parker trying to take advantage, does. Cheryl Reeve storming up and down the sideline, furious that her team could not intentionally foul LA, and now she takes a timeout.
She did not waste the timeout. She wanted her team to get the foul so she wouldn't have to waste it.
And now Cheryl Reeve is saying,
I think she got hit with a technical.
I think you might be right. She was.
She's running out of the coach's box, trying to tell her team to take a foul so she can get an injured player off the floor. That's a situation, Ryan. You don't call it technical there. She is running up the sidelines. She has an injured player. And so she's imploring her team to foul. Sylvia Fowles is hurt in front of the bench. Watch the top of the screen. Cheryl Reeve yelling at her team, foul, 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 foul. They don't hear she wants to get her injured player off the floor, and she gets called for a technical for that.
She ended up going a little bit further across center court before she was hit the technical, but in a game 5?
Come on, she's trying to get her injured player out of the game.
That doesn't need to be made right there. Instead it was, and Christy Tolliver cashes in, and Sylvia Fowles on the bench being attended to. A Minnesota Lynx team that has remained very healthy this season. Natasha Howard will come in. Augustus couldn't get that one. A loose ball scooped up by Parker.
If you're LA, look to attack the paint. You don't have the shot blocker fouls in, and that's exactly what they do.
On cue. It's a 1-point game, and Parker has 17 points. Now creates the steal. LA is in front.
Even when Sylvia Fowles isn't scoring, she rebounds and she protects the paint.
It's a 7-0 LA run. Moore hit inside, and if that's a Grubike, that's number four. If it's Carson, it's number four. And it is number four on Nneka Ogwumike as we check in with Holly for an update on Sylvia Fowles.
Sylvia Fowles has been seen to on the bench by athletic trainer Chuck Barta. She came over to the bench holding her right hand. It looks like the middle finger on her right hand, one of those joints, was out of place. He manipulated it. She was in excruciating pain as he tried to manipulate that joint. You can see him taping those two fingers together right now. But I can tell you, Sylvia Fowles is shaking on the bench. She was holding her chest. She's upset. She was in quite a bit of pain. This could be a major turning point for this team right now.
And Holly, that's something that I have done, dislocating in a finger. And more than anything, when you look down and your finger's out of place, it scares you. But you can come back and play. If they get it back into place, and especially because of where she scores from and the impact she can have, you can still come in and be effective.
How does Minnesota adjust defensively without Fowles?
They're going to have to swarm the paint. They're going to need help inside on players like Candace Parker, but she has the size advantage.
Parker now has 19 and 9 in the third. Howard trying to get to it. Was able to corral on the floor. It's going to be a jump.
And Ryan, to go back to Nneka Ogwumike's fourth foul, we saw a few possessions ago she was frustrated because she did not get the call on her end of the floor, and then to come down and have that one called on her, I can understand why there's this frustration.
Maybe need a little more leniency here in this game five.
Yeah, don't call technicals on coaches trying to get a player out, and don't call the little touch stuff, or at least just be consistent with it.
Now Cheryl Reap about to send Sylvia Fowles back into this game. You can see her kneeling near the scorer's table, so that's a good sign for Minnesota. As Brunson snatches the jump. Augustus, a three, is good! Down the other way, Beard right to the rim, lays it up and in. Oh, what action we have going in the third. And in essence, Carson gets hit with her four.
Simone Augustus, when she starts playing well, they say the Bayou Beast comes out of the LSU grad, and you see it right there.
What did Maya Moore say after game two? When the dreads get to popping and the nostrils get to flaring.
I think you saw both of them there.
Cheryl Reeve told us before the start of this series that if we're going to win, we need Simone Augustus. They've had her tonight, 13 points. She's hit five of her last six after starting 0-4. A little bit of a force there from Whalen. That last hit. Brunson, LA basketball.
Tremendous pursuit, though, by Rebecca Brunson from one side of the floor to the other, but also by Candace Parker. The energy is there for both teams.
LA scored only 11 points in the second quarter, already with 16 here in the third. They've erased a six-point halftime deficit. Parker looking to take Brunson. Aggressive, pivoting, fading, short.
With Sylvia Fowles in there, it becomes a fade.
And Ogwumike could not clean it up on the bunny. Moore the lob. Fowles is fouled on the floor. And if that's Tolliver, that's going to be number five.
But we've seen immediately the impact for Sylvia Fowles. On one end of the floor, Candace Parker has to go into a fadeaway jumper. Here she runs in transition.
Boy, if you're Christy Tolliver, don't you just have to let her catch that and lay it in?
You let it go. Christy Tolliver is integral to the success of LA. She is their best three-point shooter. She's fourth in the league in threes. But not only that, she changes the way defenses play on other players.
So now Tolliver, with her fifth personal, and we still have more than half of the third to go. How does LA respond? Beard given all kinds of space. Almost chucked it into the first row. Great Will. Game five of the finals is tied. with 4:53 to go in the third.
Last drop.
Back in Minnesota, an active Candace Parker is a dangerous Candace Parker, and she got it going and is getting it going here in the third quarter on the move, hitting her threes, and then the give and go. When she gets in the paint, she's dangerous. She has been fired up since the second half started.
And you see the difference in this postseason. In wins, she's averaged more than 23 points a game. In losses, less than 10. So far tonight, she has 19 on 8 of 15 shooting. 9 in the third. LA has won the battle in the paint here in the third quarter so far. 12-0. Bumake playing with 4 fouls. Tolliver on the bench with 5 for LA as Fouls lays it home on another delivery from Moore, her 7th assist.
Moore continues to draw defensive attention and once again makes the right decision.
Gray was hit. That's a foul on Simone Augustus. That is just the 6th foul called against Minnesota compared to 13 on LA.
You see the heads turn when Maya Moore gets the basketball. Right there, it's Candace Parker who misses the retreat back to Sylvie Fouls.
Beard goes baseline, the shovel and finish from Carson.
I think Beard has just had such good poise throughout the course of these finals. She has the toughest assignment defensively, and on the offensive end, she's done what her team has needed.
Well, they need more from her now with Tolliver out. 5 fouls. That's a force from Fouls, but saved by Moore. Brunson will cash in on the excellent effort and never giving up on the play from Maya Moore. She'll get rewarded with an assist there, number 8. Here's Parker. To a cutting Beard in traffic, 3 to shoot, Beard will. Around it off, Parker on the offensive glass, got fouled.
LA has done such a good job of attacking the glass here in game 5. So much better than we've seen throughout the earlier games in the series.
Well, they are a +1 on the glass so far tonight. They were a -16 in the game 4 loss, a -22 in games 1 and 2 combined. They were a +5 in a game 3 win. Parker misses the free throw. Hey, tonight after BYU and number 14 Boise State, don't miss Sports Center at Night with Lisa Kearney and John Anderson. They'll have a complete breakdown of Game 5 of the NLCS between the Cubs and Dodgers, Bears and Packers highlights, and everything else from the world of sports. SportsCenter at Night, also streaming live on the ESPN app, and watch ESPN. Parker now 2 of 4 from the line. She has an even 20 points.
The lineup that's on the floor right now for Minnesota, Fouls and Maya Moore are the 2 consistent scorers for this team.
Fouls putting it on the floor. 7 to shoot. Moore trying to create. Moore gets space. Can't hit on the glass. Brunson went over the back. Number 2 on Rebecca Brunson.
This is a lineup for Minnesota where it could be difficult for them to get points. Renee Montgomery has struggled. And for LA, especially with Tolliver out, look for Chelsea Gray. She did such a nice job in game 4.
Look at Perkins come up with a steal on the inbound. Montgomery tees it up. And Kansas. Will that be a play you remember? Miscommunication from LA.
And Cheryl Reeve told us, I need more from my bench. So she gets the steal from Gia Perkins, and then Renee Montgomery, who had been 0 for 4 in these finals from the 3-point line, steps up and hits the big one. She wants more from her bench on that play. Cheryl Reeve sure got it.
Minnesota's bench has outscored LA's 7-2 in this game. So not resounding production, but an impactful play there. Parker being harassed by Brunson. Brunson hanging, Parker pushed baseline, and five to shoot for LA.
Candace Parker had the clear out on the left side of the floor, but Rebecca Brunson hung nicely.
Brunson trying to become the first player with five WNBA titles. Beard in the corner, couldn't get it. And that would have been a big one.
Same spot where she hit the game winner in game one.
Fouls. Across her body. Danger time for LA. Parker. No. And that is going to be an offensive foul on Maya Moore.
We've seen Maya Moore have success doing that cut to get on the block. But that time got tagged with the offensive foul.
And that might have been a little resuscitation that LA is in desperate need of right now. Neither team is led by more than six at any point in this game. Beer storms through the lane and lays it home.
Elena Beer loves that play. Clear out, she can go to her strong left hand.
Nearly a 5 second violation on the inbound.
Lindsey Whalen getting a lot of rest here in the third quarter on the bench, Ryan.
Eight to shoot. Brunson forced it up. No. And Agumike able to snare it. Agumike playing with four fouls. Gray rumbles in and flips it home. It's a two-point game.
That's what Chelsea Gray did so effectively in game four. She got in the paint. She got to the free throw line. That's what she brings, the big, strong guard who can score inside.
Back into the arms of Moore. Montgomery. Too long for Moore. And out of bounds off of L.A. It'll be Minnesota basketball. Candace Parker and Essence Carson tried to plead their case.
And those are the passes that frustrate Cheryl Reed. Said Renee Montgomery at times can be too loose with the basketball.
Six to shoot for the defending champs. Fouls gets loose and lays it in.
I think at least right now, her fingers feel pretty good.
Six in the quarter, had just two at the half. Beard kicks, Gray got it to go.
There's a lot of players on the perimeter you can leave open. Chelsea Gray has proven in these finals, she's not one of them.
Coming off a 20-point performance in game four, in which he was 4 of 5 from deep. Perkins, no. Agumike the rebound, and time for LA. LA has to hurry, they don't realize it. Carson will heave, and that'll do it. Boy, are we set up for a fun fourth. 15 lead changes, 9 ties. No deficit greater than 6 points, and it's at 1 for LA.
Challenge Sylvia Fowles to be more of an option, and then she dislocates a finger. How did you approach that situation when she was trying to get some help?
I haven't talked to her since then. I mean, you know, it's pretty painful, but she stayed focused through it.
Chelsea Gray's gotten going a little bit here. She hurt you in game three, 20 points. How do you get her more attention?
Well, you know, we can't overhelp and then not close back out to her.
Thanks, Coach.
Well, after 16 combined turnovers in the first half, only 4 in the third, some excellent basketball and 1 quarter left to decide the championship. The LA Sparks trying to win their first title since 2002. Minnesota trying to repeat and make it 4 titles in 6 years. Gray, tough shot, but she got it!
Again, they cleared out the right side of the floor for Chelsea Gray on the smaller rail, and we've seen her do that time and again in this series.
Gray has the last 7 for LA. She's had to step up. Christy Tolliver on the bench with five fouls for Los Angeles. Augustus floats it, banks it.
Simone Augustus will go quiet for a little while on the offensive end, but then she can come roaring back with pretty plays.
15 for Augustus. Gray leans in, got another.
I mean, when you see Chelsea Gray's frame, she can absorb contact easily and still get her shot up.
18 lead changes. Whalen harassed by Beard. Here's fouls. Nice look. Whalen.
Cheryl Rivas told us she thinks Lindsey Whalen is the best cutting point guard that the league has ever seen.
Minnesota with 21 assists on their 24 field goals. Gray. Oh, she did it again.
Chelsea Gray in her second year in the league, her first year in Los Angeles, showing what she can do once again here.
11 straight for Gray for LA. Whalen leans in, forced it up, no whistle, and Boumake the rebound. LA is not led by more than two at any point in this game. Gray to Carson on a three. No, Boumake. Oh, what a putback.
And right now, LA is in attack mode, going at the rim, successful doing it. Cheryl Reeve knows she needs a timeout.
Largest lead of the game for the LA Sparks.
We've got an MVP on the floor. Her name is Nneka Ogwumike. Look at that. So pretty.
In their new era when they host the Rockets. Coverage of opening night begins with NBA Countdown. Charged by Due at 7. Both games are streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. You saw Andrew Wiggins, Ricky Rubio. Two talented players for what should be a talented Minnesota Timberwolves team. Here the Lynx trail by three, LA's largest lead of this winner-take-all game five. Whalen with seven to shoot, finds Perkins on a three. Ogwumike and fouls jockeying, and it's LA who wins it.
Minnesota in their smaller lineup. So with that, Nneka Ogwumike was guarding Lindsey Whalen, able to help off and get to the glass.
Six to shoot. Parker makes her move, pulls up, and hits!
Maya Moore now with the defensive assignment on Candace Parker, so they run screening action to get fouls on the switch.
22 for Candace Parker. Moore gives it up. Fouls, puts it in. Assists for Maya Moore to go with 17 points and 5 boards. Gray double. Parker on the move to the rim. Lays it up and in. Candace Parker is possessed tonight.
In game four, Maya Moore had the best of Candace Parker in that matchup. Here in game five, it's Candace who's thriving.
Took a lot of responsibility for the game four loss. Augustus can't answer. Rebound out of bounds as we check in with Holly.
Well, talking to a dejected LA Sparks team in the locker room after game four, their biggest focus was on rebounding. They got crushed on the board, 41-25 in game four. They vowed to be better tonight, and boy are they. They are leading Minnesota right now, 27-22 on the rebounding edge. Candace Parker, who had just three in the last game, said, "I was embarrassed." She's got 10 tonight.
And she's putting it on the floor and getting her shot. That time couldn't hit, but there's another rebound, this time on the offensive end.
Nneka and Candace are getting it done, but their guards have also come in and mixed it up. Beard on that one.
Gray kicks. Beard halfway down and out, and an opportunity for Minnesota. Whalen's pull-up. You bet. You didn't think the defending champs were going away, did you? And that is going the other way. And that is going to be number five on Nika Igbuemeke.
Just a heady play by the veteran Gia Perkins to step in and take this. She knows NECA's coming. She braces. She's stationary. And that's the right call.
And so now Igbuemeke with five. And Christy Tolliver back on the floor with five. She departed midway through the third when the score was 44-all.
And again, Igbuemeke is the one defending Lindsey Whalen. Can Minnesota capitalize on that?
Beard pokes. Augustus, a three. No, fouls keeps it alive. Moore, with two to shoot. Moore, no fouls again. And a foul on the floor on Chelsea Gray, who is switched up on fouls right now. Or is it going to be on? Yes, it will be on Gray. And you see the foul trouble on Nika Igbuemeke, as well as Tolliver and Carson. Make that Parker who gets hit with the personal her first. So no concern for Candace, but you see Igbuemeke and Tolliver, key players with five. Augustus right by Tolliver, took advantage, couldn't finish, and the rebound tipped away by Parker to Tolliver.
And I think that's what you do. You continue to try to exploit the fact that Tolliver has those five fouls.
Eight to shoot. Tolliver wedged against Igbuemeke, three to shoot. Tolliver has to heave, and somehow
we've seen Christy Tolliver hit tough shot after tough shot. I don't know how she got that one to go down, though.
That was the appropriate bench reaction. Perkins can't answer. Parker with the ball. LA with its largest lead. Candace Parker seeking her first title. She's accomplished virtually everything else you can. Tolliver! No. Parker on the offensive glass, snatches it away for two.
I think Minnesota needs Rebecca Brunson back in the ball game. She is the one who gets to the glass.
Timeout Minnesota. Largest lead of the game for either team. It's eight for the Sparks.
Christy Tolliver has told Holly Rowe she thinks she's the greatest clutch shooter in the WNBA. Well, that's a circus one right there. Gets it to fall. Five fouls, 3 points. Attack mode on the offensive end, just a completely different energy that she's brought here in game four, makes such an impact on her teammates.
Meanwhile, Maya Moore has not scored in the last 14 minutes of game action. Her last points, two free throws with 6:46 to go in the third.
Elena Beard has done a tremendous job limiting her.
And a whistle. Defensive 3 seconds called against LA. And maybe this free throw from Moore could get her going.
She's been looking to be more of a facilitator and assister here in this second half. She needs to be a scorer here in the last 2:49.
Puts that one down. Lindsey Whalen in Minnesota has been here before. Three titles in the last 5 years, including last season winning a game five right here against Indiana. Moore for three. She got it. She's a scorer again. Tolliver trap needs help. Gray shovels it out. Beard, with three to shoot, hesitated. Parker has to heave. She didn't get it off in time. Well, we'll say she did. Here's Moore. Moore bodying in, giving it up. Brunson gets the roll. A 6-0 run from the Minnesota Lynx, and this is a two-point game with 1:53 to go.
We've talked about Maya Moore being one of the greatest winners in the history of women's basketball. When she caught that ball, her feet were not even squared at the basket. She knows how to make these plays in these huge moments.
This sellout crowd on its feet. And Whalen steals the inbound. Gray can't hit. Beard the offensive board, and L.A. can reset and perhaps breathe. Five to shoot. Someone needs to hurry for L.A. Agumake puts it up and in, but that one is going to be reviewed, and I'm not sure it's going to count when it is.
Great defense by Minnesota. The last timeout, Cheryl Reeve telling her team, we need stops. But Agumake still able to get one down.
Didn't seem like Gray was aware the shot clock only resets to 14. Augustus, you bet! For now, this game is tied. But the Agumake bucket will be reviewed. Tolliver! No! Inside, fouls the board. And Cheryl Reeve will take a timeout. Minnesota tied right now. But in a moment, they'll be up by two. Because they'll review that bucket, and it'll be cleared. Okay, tip-off on TNT. Knicks at Cleveland. Spurs at Warriors. Wednesday on ESPN. Philly hosts OKC. Houston at L.A. For more on these games, please go to NBA.com or visit the NBA app. Now, even though the officials indicated they were going to review Nneka Agumake's bucket, they are not allowed to. So it is 73-all. Once the action continued, they cannot then go back and review that bucket. So that bucket counts for Nneka Agumake, even though we saw on the replay to break, it was clearly after the shot clock. So this game is, in fact, tied. Minnesota could go 2-for-1 here. Whalen finds Moore for the lead. No, Brunson the offensive board. Denied inside, but got the whistle. And if that's Agumake, it's number six. But it will be Carson's fifth.
Everyone knew that Maya Moore was the one who was going to be getting the shot. Rebecca Brunson did what she's done throughout the season, getting to the offensive glass. Foul. Was that on Agumake?
No, it was on Carson.
I thought that was Agumake's foul the way she was reaching over.
Instead, it's on Carson, and Brunson misses the free throw. LA with two timeouts, Minnesota with one. Brunson gives Minnesota the lead. Timeout Sparks. Right, 74-73, Minnesota in front of LA. Game five. This winner take all.
contest of these 2016 finals. It's been an unbelievable finals. It's been incredibly memorable. Interesting, controversial play. Because they did not review it immediately on Neko Gumake's bucket to put LA up by two, they could not then go back and review it once action continued. And as a result, a bucket counts that probably shouldn't have. Now you'll see the official signal for a review here at the top of your screen. A timeout taken by Minnesota. Now neither team with any timeouts remaining. And Candace Parker has 20.
Brilliant pass to Candace Parker with the finish. The finish, that's what she's been doing all night.
Candace Parker said so often in her career, she would perform.
No timeout. Here we go.
But her teammates would not. This postseason, these finals, she felt like her teammates performed, but she had not. She's performed tonight. Now Minnesota a chance to take the champions.
Something happened. That's your league MVP right there. Relentless, continues to attack. Whew, what a game. And Brian Agler gets another championship for himself and the first for Candace Parker and Igbumike.
The Minnesota Lynx visibly stunned, losing on their home floor in a game five that will go down. Well, Candace Parker, referring to Pat Summitt, her mentor who she lost this year, and Magic Johnson celebrating with his team as we check back in with Holly.
Well, Mecca, this team's so emotional as you see Candace, a star who's been without a title for such a long time. You're telling her this is for her. Why did your team want it so much for your star?
She's been through so much. She's been through so much. She's probably the most misunderstood person in the league, and she deserves this. And I told her that I wanted her to get one more than anybody else, and she deserves this more than anyone. She had an awesome game tonight. She's been our leader. And it's just a very emotional time right now. We knew we could do it, but we're the only ones that knew we could do it. And I'm so happy for everybody. We went through so much, Holly, and I'm just so thankful.
You guys had a 7-point lead with just 2 minutes to play in this game. They're trying to get your mom to you. And 7-point lead that almost squandered. How were you able to come back and get these shots at the end when they mattered the most?
I mean, honestly, coming into this game, I knew it was going to be hard. But I told myself I have to think like a role player. And that's what I did. I wanted to come in, get every rebound, set screens, run for my team. I don't care if I have 0 points. I wanted to do what I could for my team, and that's what I knew that I had to do for us to win.
All right, go hug your mom.
All right, Holly, well, plenty more to come. Neka Gumake with the game winner. Candace.
2016 WNBA champion, the Los Angeles Sparks.
Candace Parker.
Nice.
On a year where she was first left off the Olympic team and then
dealt with personal tragedy and losing one of her closest people in her life in Pat Summitt, ends this year with a championship and the finals MVP. Her first title, and her team wins it in dramatic fashion here against the Minnesota Lynx. And after the game, she shared some special moments with Magic Johnson.
Thank you so much for believing in us. Thank you so much for believing in us.
And then,
thank you.
And then you came out and you did it. Right?
Oh.
No.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
No, it was you.
Thank you.
In that fourth quarter, you did your thing.
Well, it feels like the perfect poetic circular ending for Candace Parker, who began this year being snubbed, dealt with tragedy, then again recently snubbed again, left off either the first or second all WNBA team, but here she could not have been better in this deciding game five, and her owner obviously appreciative of her efforts.
As she took the responsibility on her shoulders, she told Holly Rowe, I haven't done what I needed to do in this playoffs or in these finals, but she sure did here in game five. From the get-go, was intense, was in attack mode, just made the big plays that her team needed from her.
This is a wild game. Neither team had a double-digit lead at any point. We had four lead changes in the final 23 seconds of the game. Let's look back at some of the key moments of the fourth quarter, including some controversy as well that will be talked about for a long time.
Well, this is one thing that Minnesota in particular will point to. This last second shot by Neko Gumake does not get off in time for the shot clock. The lead official says we're going to review it, but by rules, you have to stop and review it right there. And then this is a situation, Cheryl Reeve calls a timeout. She looks at the official and says, review the play. I think that's why she called the timeout. And why is that so important? Because at the end of the game, with 3 seconds left, she no longer had that timeout. I think she burned it looking for them to review that call.
And those were crucial buckets, because that Neko Gumake bucket put LA up 73-71. Minnesota then tied it, changed strategy, but in the final 2 minutes, you have to call that immediately. But the Sparks win it down the stretch in dramatic fashion. Coming up next, it's SportsCenter for Bruce and Rodney Vaughn, Bonnie Riley, Rebecca Lobo, and Holly Rowe and LaChyna Robinson. I'm Ryan Rucco saying thanks and congrats to LA.